Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Brian with Prestigious Electric, and today we're going to be talking about the tools every electrical apprentice needs. So if you're thinking about becoming an electrician, stick around. Okay, guys, so this is going to be my office for this video. This is the lift that I'm operating today with my scissor lift. I'm using it to move it around. And this is my basic tool pouch. The tools that I carry with me on a daily basis. And the very first one I carry is my tape measure. I use the Klein 25 foot with the magnetic tip, and the purpose of that is, say I'm standing here and I want to take a measurement, it will literally stick to the wall and hold itself so I can get my measurement. So that's a really neat thing. I really love it. You know, it'll stick to it, and it's a decent magnet. So that's my first tool. I use it every day, so it stays on my side. 25 foot Klein magnetic tape. You can use any brand, but I prefer the magnetic. Alright, next tool we have a pair of Klein side cutters. This is the Journeyman series. And then I have the matching diagonal cutters, also known as dykes. You're going to need a good pair of wire strippers. I actually have a couple of different ones that I use. And then I've got these I just got. They are both wire strippers and side cutters in one. I love this because it's basically putting those two tools into one. Okay, you're gonna need a hot stick. It's a non-contact tester. You can put this up to an electric line and it will tell you if it has voltage. And this model also has a flashlight on it. You are going to need Allen keys. And I use the Klein key set. It's got all of those different sizes on it. And I actually have both because those are the larger ones. And then I have the one that has the smaller sizes on it as well. So I have all my Allen wrenches taken care of. Use a good Klein torpedo level with strong rare earth magnets. Stick to anything. I also have another level. This is just a beater, a cheaper model. The magnets are weaker, but this is the one I use that I use as a straight edge a lot of times, or just a backup if someone needs to borrow it. So I have my levels. Then I have another pair of side cutters. 10 snips. These are good for cutting sheet metal. Cable cutters. These are good for cutting cable, just bigger strands of cable besides just Romex and stuff. Stake-on tool or a crimp tool. See, it's got those little grooves right there. It's used for crimping. Of course, you're gonna need Phillips and flathead screwdrivers. You're also going to need square tip screwdriver. Let's see where I can find it. There. You're going to also need a square tip. I can't get it to focus. It's not focusing. There we go. All right, so yeah, that's a square tip. Very common. Also, an 11-in-1. It has multiple different tools on it. And I also have this 11-in-1, which actually has a tap tool on it. It will re-fix the threads if they get screwed up. Yeah, there you go. It will fix the threads of different sizes. I'll pull that out. Yeah, there you go. Okay, let me fix my camera, guys. Okay, that's better. Now I got my first person point of view going on. Where did I put that? Okay, this thing. This is for my tap tool. Stick it back in the handle. This is a bit extension. It holds the little bits that go in different tools. It sits in there and it can go in the drill. And it's flexible, which is perfect. I stick it in there, stick it in my drill, and get it in tight places because it bends. And you're gonna need wrenches. I prefer ratchet wrenches. You're gonna need standard sizes mainly. We don't use hardly anything metric in this field. And the sizes you're gonna need are gonna range from 1/4 inch, 5/16, 3/8, 7/16, 1/2 inch, 9/16. Those are the main ones. And then occasionally you're gonna need like 5/8 and 3/4, a little bit bigger ones, but you won't need those quite as often. Nut drivers, they are basically sockets on a screwdriver. I prefer the nut driver multi-tool. It's all of the sizes in one. Mine is like a 7-in-1, I believe. It has sizes for all the ones I just mentioned. It's got 1/4, 11/32, 7/16, 3/8, 5/16, 9/16, 1/2 inch. I think that's it. So just depending on which one I need, which size I need, I set it and go to town. Let's see. Also, you got a beater screwdriver. This has a metal tip on the back. This is for sticking against something. You bang on the back of it, and it won't mess the screwdriver up. It's kind of like using a screwdriver as a chisel. You'll do that a lot of times for lock nuts. You're going to need a marker and a pencil. I prefer the Milwaukee markers. They're called ink zolls, and they have this clip where you can clip it on your hard hat. Very convenient. And last but not least, a reamer. You're gonna need a reamer for reaming out your pipe after you cut it. So there you have it. Those are the basic tools that every apprentice is gonna need at the minimum. There's other tools you'll need that you'll get as you go, but those are the tools you're gonna need as minimum. So I hope you guys found this information helpful, informative. And if you enjoyed my content, then please hit the subscribe button and the bell notification so you get notified when I come out with my new videos. I will try to post as often as I can. I don't really have a set schedule like Sundays at 6 o'clock or whatever, 3 times a week. But here in the beginning, when I'm just getting started, I'm going to post as much content that I can as often as I can. So I can go ahead and get a bank of videos in there and something for you guys to watch and get my foot in the door. And this is also a learning experience. You know, every video I do, I'm hoping to get the quality to be better, hoping to get the information, the content to be better, hoping to be more entertaining, hoping to be more of what you guys want to see. So if you have any suggestions, questions, comments, anything like that, leave it in the comment section below. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and I will see you guys next time.
Okay, guys. Later. So this right here is a very important tip. You should always add this to your checklist to double check everything, especially double check that you have everything when you're packing up your tools and leaving, so you don't have to go back, so you're not missing something. Speaking of which, I'm not seeing what I'm looking for. Okay, so the lull's gone and the lift's been moved. So somebody's moved it and has it right now. So what I'm gonna do is keep walking until I find it. I would say a lot of jobs you spend half of your time looking for stuff because most jobs are so disorganized. People who grab stuff, make miscellaneous boxes of different material, carry it somewhere to use it. And then when they're done, that miscellaneous box never gets sorted back out into the different material. Or they'll go and they'll grab a whole box of something, like a whole box of connectors, and take it off where they're working. And then nobody else knows where they are when they go to get some, instead of just getting, you know, 3 or 4, however many they need. Now, if you need a whole box, that's different. But, you know, if you just need a couple, just go grab what you need. Maybe one or two extra. But don't take them all if you don't need them all, because the next man might need some. Just my tip of the day. And okay, so sorry, let me adjust the camera. This is what I forgot that I'm gonna need. That's about a $40 tool, I think. Side cutters, the Klein Journeyman series side cutters. I think they're about $40 or close to that. Bit too much to leave behind. But luckily I noticed it before I left. I was at my car and all I had to do was walk back onto the job site and find them. They were on the Lull, which I was operating earlier. So yeah, tip of the day, make sure you have everything before you leave so you don't have to drive back a long way, wasting time, money, and gas coming back to get it. And while looking at this, I think it might be about time to shave. When it warms up, I'm going to do a shave your head challenge. See who will join me. See how many views I can get from that. So, anyway, y'all have a great day. This is Brian signing off. Until next time.